Hi, this is Blair Telemar from Farmpreneur Academy, and today I want to talk to you about my genetic journey. So my journey started on December 28th at about 1:25 p.m. 2017. And it was the moment that my son was born. He was over on the exam table. The neonatologist was kind of making sure that he was breathing okay and his color looked good and doing his test for phenylketonuria. So he has a very, very deep sacral dimple at the very base of his spine. So she was holding him on his little belly and she was looking at his bottom, and she was very concerned, and I noticed that she was kind of focusing on that area. And so I asked her what it was, and she said, "Well, it looks like there's a hole here. If I can't see the bottom of it, we're gonna have to do an ultrasound." So I thought that was kind of strange, but his sister has the same thing. I just kind of thought it was a birthmark or something, but she has the same dimple. So I told her that, and you know, I said she's fine, and you know, that made her happy. So they put his diaper on and handed him to me, and so I got to hang out with him for the first time ever. But the next time, whenever I changed him, I actually noticed, like I looked and I could see what she was talking about, and it was more than a dimple. It's kind of hard to explain, but I mean, it looks like a very tiny hole, and it's very difficult. It's deep enough that you cannot see the skin at the bottom. Imagine looking into like a tiny, any belly button. That's kind of what it looks like. And it's at the base of his spine, so it's maybe just like half an inch below the top of his butt crack. And I looked at it and it really got me thinking. I was like, how close could he have been to having this neural tube defect? And I took folic acid through my whole pregnancy, both pregnancies, but my daughter's was much less pronounced. So then I'm thinking, I took folic acid my whole pregnancy, but folic acid doesn't work for everyone. I know that from my training as a pharmacist, that some people can't methylate folic acid and need to take a methylated version. You know, it's kind of the direct-to-consumer genetic tests and DNA kits are coming out. So 23andMe and Ancestry has a new health panel, and there's all kinds of different direct-to-consumer DNA kits available. So what I did was I bought one for myself, probably in February or March, and I tested myself to see if I was one of those people. And I was very surprised when my results came back and showed that I was one of those people that could not methylate folic acid. So it's not a big deal if you know about it, you just take a methylated version of folic acid, but it was never crossed my mind, even as a pharmacist, to see if my folic acid was even working, and it was never brought up in any of my OBGYN appointments that it may be something to consider. So I want to share my story because so many people are out there getting 23andMe and DNA type test kits, but I think that we can use them to learn more about ourselves than just our ancestry. We can learn more about how our bodies metabolize drugs. We can learn about how our bodies affect the nutrient levels. We know many of us are depleted in B12 and vitamin D and lots of these very common nutrients. And some of that is due to genetic factors. So I want to encourage everyone, if you've had a 23andMe test or you've had some of these direct-to-consumer DNA test kits done, to share them with a healthcare professional, or you know, just look through them, take them to your local pharmacist and have them, you know, sit down and look through the results with you. Because if you see something like the mutation that I have, which is called MTHFR, it stands for methyl tetrahydrofolate reductase. So we say MTHFR. And if you have something like that, it's not a big deal. But if you are a woman of childbearing age, you've already had one child, or you're thinking about having a child, it's definitely worth a look, and it's worth the $99 or whatever it is to go get the test done so that you can be 100% sure that the folic acid you're taking is actually actually working for your body. So I'm Blair Thielemeyer from Pharmapreneur Academy. I am so excited to share my message and share more about how pharmacists can make a difference in the lives of patients by offering advanced clinical pharmacy services like genetic testing.